My name is Moshawa, and in this video, I will show you how to integrate PC-lint Plus into your IAR Embedded Workbench IDE. PC-lint Plus can be integrated into all the popular IDEs. This is accomplished by providing information to the IDE, like the path to the PC-lint Plus executable, a .lnt file to customize the output of PC-lint Plus for each IDE, and lastly, the compiler configuration and project configuration if needed. The result of the integration would allow you to experience PC-lint Plus in a way that's familiar, and allows for quick results when developing with location references, meaning you can simply click on the message issued and it will take you to the location of the emission. If you still need to create compiler configurations, you can follow the link in the description to set up compiler configurations for the IAR compiler. Keep in mind, if you still need to download PC-lint Plus, you can watch the first 2 minutes of the video that can also be found in the description. So let's get started. We will start by locating the LNT file that we need for the IAR compiler. So by opening up where the PC-lint Plus folder is located, we'll be able to find the LNT directory, which includes that file, and it will be located here. We can take a copy of this and add it to the configuration that we have created in the last video. So if you haven't done so already, you can go back and check out the video to create the compiler configurations for the IAR compiler, and we can add the LNT file to this folder. Make sure that you don't alter the content of the LNT file. And now we can open up the Embedded Workbench IDE. From here, we can click on Tools, Configure Tools, click on New. And we'll change the name here to Analyze Current File with PC-lint Plus. And for the command, we will browse. Once you have located the executable, you'll be able to hit Open. For the arguments, we have a few to add. I'm going to show you what those are. The arguments consist of the minus U option, the minus I option, with the location or where the .lnt file is located, along with the configuration. And lastly, the file path argument, which provides the current file path. If you wanted to run PC-lint Plus on an entire project instead, you can substitute the file path option with the project directory option instead. But for the purposes of the demonstration, I'm going to focus on the current file. We can take the command and add it to the arguments. And from here, we'll click on redirect to output window. If you would like PC-lint Plus to pop up every single time asking you for additional arguments, you can prompt for command line arguments. And from here, you can click OK. I would like to have PC-lint Plus to be easily accessible. This is optional, but you can add PC-lint Plus to the toolbar by clicking on the toolbar options, add or remove buttons, customize. And from here, we will have the pop-up. And from the pop-up, we'll choose the tools. Scroll down to see Analyze Current File with PC-lint Plus and drag it to where we want it to be displayed. Hit Close. And now every time we want to run PC-lint Plus, we simply click on the option and we'll be able to run it. Another thing that we can do is assign a keyboard shortcut to run PC-lint Plus. And we would do that by, we will click on Tools, Options. And from here, we'll look at Key Bindings. We'll click on the file drop-down menu and then click on Tools. And from here, we will scroll down to see Analyze Current File with PC-lint Plus. We will click on Press Key Shortcut. And for me, I'm going to assign it the shortcut Control-Shift-P. And I'm going to set. And this will add it. And we can confirm it here. Click OK. And now we can run PC-lint Plus with the shortcut Control-Shift-P or by clicking Analyze Current File with PC-lint Plus. And from here, we'll be able to test out the integration by opening up a file and simply clicking Analyze Current File with PC-lint Plus. From here, we can see that there is a warning, 530, for the variable K. Once I click on it, I'll be taken into where that emission was. And there's also a supplemental message saying where K was referenced and the allocation was here. To resolve this issue, we would take out the initialization of K to outside of the function, and we'll save the code and analyze with PC-lint Plus once more. And from here, we can see that we were able to resolve the warning. To make sure that there isn't any configuration issues, you can also include a directory save and run with PC-lint Plus. You can see that I don't have any configuration issues, but let's just pretend that I don't have any configuration, and I can take out the configuration from the utility by taking out the config lnt from the reference of the argument. Once this is taken out, I can save it and run it again. And from here, you'll be able to see that PC-lint Plus is unable to find where the header is located because there is no configuration that tells PC-lint Plus of that location. I hope you have found this video to be helpful. To go further, feel free to check out the reference manual included in the doc directory. If you're running into any issues or have video topic suggestions, feel free to chat to us on support@pc-lintplus.com. Have a good one.